Good evening. My guest tonight is among the most accomplished communicators in the country, if not the world. But most of you probably don't recognize his name or won't recognize his face. I guarantee you all know his work.
These things look very simple, but they take forever to do.
Although I think graphic design is one of those phrases that doesn't mean anything, because anything that's graphic is graphic. Painting or dancing, if you see it. Writing, if you see it, it's graphic, graphic, graphic. There are many good definitions. One is the synthesis of form and content. Or the manipulation of form and content. Or the management of form and content. Or the...
If you're asked to design a logo, for example, the logo that's representative of some recognizable object will be accepted much faster than any other kind. The object of a logo is to be recognizable, is a signature, and it could be anything. So a logo can be abstract, it could be anything. It could be a dot, it could be a square.
But people will always see things. You know, perception is reality. Reality is not reality. It's only what people think.
Oh, one of my favorite things that he's done, of course, is the IBM poster with the I, the B, and the M. It was very powerful.
Before 1960, nobody had stripes, at least not on their logo.
It's much easier to think of him as an artist, but I actually think of Paul as much as a business problem solver.
I think you're sort of well known in design circles for not showing or believing in showing a client a whole slew of options. You just like you present.
No, I think for the same reason that a doctor doesn't give you a million choices. You know, if you got a headache, he'll give you an aspirin.
Trying to be original, just trying to be good.